reach for the speed, reach for the whistle, go where the rail may run. Reach for the words, reach for the story, follow the rainbow sun. To a shining time station, where dreams can come true, waiting there for me.
The full bucket line was getting busier. The engines had to work harder and harder. They began to tire out more and more. Could not wait to rest when the day was done. But none of the engines got as tired of the whole train was day and night, and got very little sleep. One day, Luke was resting when Mr. Iverson told him he had an important job to do. A train of general goods needed to be taken to Lakehurst. Now, Mr. Iverson knew Luke would not be happy since he had just arrived with the bucket liner daylight. But still, Luke sleepily went on to find his job. An hour later, Luke arrived with his train to find Steve and Dan waiting in a siding.
Well, 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 Dan, look who's here. Mr. Golden State.
Hey, guys. Where do you want these boxcars?
You're late. We don't accept things that come in late.
Knock it off. Where do you want them?
Ooh, Mr. Tough Guy. He's trying to boss us around. He must think he's more important.
Okay, for the last time, where do you want them? If you don't, I'll take them back.
Put them on the second siding. If you don't think that is where it should go, Mr. Important.
5 minutes later, Luke was shunting the boxcars into the second siding. Just then, he heard a strange noise.
Huh? Who's there? Is that you, Utes? Chris? Anybody?
Utes was resting in a siding. He heard Luke call his name, so he went to see why.
Hey, Luke. What's up? Utes, was that you?
What was me?
Never mind.
They heard a humming, but it was only Dylan.
Good night, Luke. Good night, Luke.
Not Dylan.
Yeah, not Dylan.
That night, a strange engine came into the yard. Unseen, the engine coupled up to the boxcars and puffed away. When morning came, Steve and Dan were shocked.
What the? They're not here. Luke messed up. It's good to hear that. I mean, we told him right here. Yeah, how hard is it to put a couple of boxcars in a siding?
Steve and Dan went looking for Luke, but it didn't take long. They found him in Simon.
I delivered them!
No, you didn't. They're not there.
I swear, I put them there!
I think you're trying to get us in trouble. You said it, Dan.
No, I didn't. I put them in the second siding.
So, where are they then?
Jimmy had been shutting the train he and Luke had just pulled up with, and he went over to defend Luke.
You better shut up and leave Luke alone. I believe him.
No, you shut up, you good-for-nothing pile of junk.
Why, you little...
The argument went on and on until Big Mac came to break it up.
Shut up. What's going on over here?
Luke hit the boxcar so we can't find them, and we'll get in trouble if we don't deliver them.
I deliver them!
Obviously, you haven't heard. 3 cars full of locomotive parts just went missing. Everyone was doing something, so they couldn't have stolen them. Mr. Strupp and Mr. Iverson have a plan to track down the culprit. Now, Alf, get to 4 Fairfax immediately.
Yes, sir.
La 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 la, I'm not listening to you.
Jimmy.
Let's take it, I'll get going.
All the engines hurry.
Thank you.
done very well, Pate.
But you still owe us.
You're breaking your promise.
Well, we are bread, guys. Right, Tucker?
Right, Eddie. Now, do what we say or your brother will meet the bottom of the ravine.
We had a deal.
But now we have a new one. I'm out, Oliver. There's some cars carrying diesel oil, coal, and wire. Go get them!
Don't do it. Don't listen to them.
Otto, I must. This is the last one, right?
Of course. But if you don't, Otto is a pile of smashed steel. I cracked myself.
Laughing, Eddie and Tucker back out of the sight deeper into the yard to plan their escape.
You alright, Otto?
Don't do it. I'm not worth it.
Unknown to Tucker and Eddie, Dylan had witnessed the entire thing and he began to worry.
Oh man, I have to find Luke and Oots.
Mr. Iverson and Mr. Strupp had paired up the engines and told them to go to plant fuel trains as bait. Steve and Dan went to Fort Fairbanks.
We'll get this criminal. Yeah, and think of the reward.
Tyler was in Lake Hurst waiting for his partner to show up. He was told that he would arrive soon.
Fuel train in place. Alarm ready to go off. Now, where is my partner?
Hey, Tyler.
God, Jimmy. Of all the angels I get to the shadow box.
Man, it's gonna be great when we catch that thief and we give him a warning.
Yeah, how great will that be?
At Simonville, Big Mac and Chris were waiting on a sight.
Now, when you see the thief, trigger the alarm and block the switch at the far side of the sign so he can't escape.
Okay, then you couple up to the back of a train and hold him, right?
Right.
Big Mac and Chris sat and waited for a long time.
Big Mac? Why am I up in front?
Well, if the thief comes up and sees you, it gets you.
What?
Just kidding.
Should I? Yeah, I should. Boo! Ah! Shut up, Chris. It's me.
What the? Brad? I thought you were getting repaired.
It's not hard to replace a fuel lad. Now what's going on over here?
Get in the siding and we'll tell you.
Don't do that again.
Later at St. Joseph, Luke and Oots were waiting. It seemed to take forever until Dylan rushed in and told Luke and Oots everything. They all agreed to find Pete.
So why are we leaving our post? Big Mac wanted us to pick up some cars and chose. Wait, Brad. Look. Luke and Oots are leaving with Dylan. What are they doing?
Gotta figure this out.
Chris, come on. We'll follow them.
What about Big Mac?
Don't worry, he'll be fine. Come on, let's go.
Pete was going down the main line toward the abandoned yard. Dylan sprinted ahead of Pete over a switch track and stopped in front of him. Pete slammed on his brakes and stopped just in time.
What's going on?
Don't worry, we're here to help you. You can trust us.
How do you know?
I heard your conversation with the other engines in the yard.
Whoop, quick, boy!
The four engines saw that Brad and Chris were looking for them.
I have an idea. Quick, everybody, into the yard.
They rushed into the yard and hid out of sight from Brad, Chris, Tucker, and Eddie.
So, what's your plan?
Okay, Brad and Chris will come in because they had to have seen us.
But Tucker and Eddie will chase them away.
Yeah, but when they go after them, Dylan will go to free Otto.
Sure thing.
Then Pete, Oots, and I will go out and couple up to Eddie and Tucker and hold them back.
Good idea. Get ready. Here they come.
Brad and Chris slowly came into the yard in search of Dylan, Oots, and Luke.
Brad, this place is giving me the creeps. Hold on. We'll look around real quick, and then we'll get out of here. That's weird. I thought I saw them come in here.
Okay.
Wait, look! It's the boxcars! Good job! Quick, send a signal!
Hey, what are you two doing here?
Brad, it's the thieves.
Yeah. Shall we make a run for it?
Oh yeah, let's do it.
Okie dokie.
Brad and Chris took off screaming. They took off so fast that they forgot to trigger the alarm.
Let's get them.
Alright!
Okay, I'm going in.
Good. Pete, Oots, after them! Pete, Oots, and Luke took off after the criminals. Dylan went in to find Otto.
What's going on out there? What was that?
Easy, Otto.
Who are you?
A friend. Now let's get you out of here.
Meanwhile, on the main line, Luke, Pete, and Woods were closing in on Tucker and Eddie. When Brad and Chris saw them give them pursuit, they blew their horns as loud as they could. Big Mac heard them and raised the alarm.
Hear that? It's the alarm. Let's go.
Meanwhile, Lakehurst.
Let's get going. All right. Jimmy, look out for the...
Tyler? Would you mind calling a crane and a fire truck?
Meanwhile, down the main line, Big Mac pulled onto the main line from Simonville. He blew his horn to warn Brad and Chris he was there.
Lance, Big Mac, brake hard!
Right!
Brad and Chris slammed on their brakes. Eddie and Tucker, to avoid the accident, did the same.
Great.
Alright, grab him! Oots, Luke, and Pete ran as fast as they could and coupled up to Tucker and Eddie. They could try to escape. They stopped with Pete, Brad, and Chris.
Ooh.
Now we got ya.
Looks like it's the end of the line for the both of you. I always wanted to say that.
In the morning, a full bucket line cop police came to Fort Fairfax to take Eddie and Tucker away. The engines watched as Lo and Joe prepared to take them away. Captain Bordy pulled out to talk to Luke.
Well, Luke, we can't think enough. These guys have been chasing these two for months.
Thanks, Bodie. I couldn't have done it without doing Pete Woods, though.
Well, we still can't thank enough.
Hey, Captain. Let's go. If we hurry, we can make it to the prison yard by lunch.
Yeah, those troops not doing their time.
No.
We'll be back. Mark my words.
Yeah, shut up. Let's go, boys. Well, Luke, you saved the day.
Well, like I said, I couldn't have done about you guys.
Thanks, though.
Yeah, thanks.
Same for me.
Hey, look, nice job on catching Tucker and Eddie. All right, same thing for you, Dylan.
Jimmy, don't you have something to say to Woods?
No, but I think it really hurt.
I should have expected that.
Anyway, thanks for helping me and saving my brother.
It was our pleasure. An engine in his need is a friend indeed. Definitely. Hey, that rhymes.
Well, better be on our way.
If you ever need anything, just call the death ray when you're around.
We'll remember that.
Come on, Greg. Let's go. See you guys later.
Pete and Otto departed to head back to their own line. When they were out of sight, Dylan remembered he had to get going.
Speaking of line, I better get back on mine. Mr. Wilson will be wondering where I am.
See you later.
Okay, bye guys.
Later that day, Boots and Luke were pulling into Lakehurst with the cars that Tucker and Eddie forced Pete to steal. They shunted the cars into place and saw Brad and Chris. He decided to go talk to them.
Hey guys, thanks for helping us out.
Well, if we didn't, we would.
At least your name is cleared, Luke.
Yeah, thanks. Hey, were you guys even scared at all?
Nah. We weren't scared, right, Chris?
Right.
Oh my god, they're back!
Huh, we're not being scared, they're awfully loud and fast.
Yeah, they sure are. Well, I think that was a really good day.
Definitely.
Life was back to normal on the full bucket line. Luke, Oots, and Dylan are glad to have their new friends. They are sure that they'll see them again, but they hope never see Tucker and Eddie ever again.
The Great Pacific Railway for California hail. Bring on the locomotive, lay down the iron rail. Across the rolling prairies, by steam we're bound to go. The rail.